When on America's eastern plains still roamed her forest child, and the new homes of Europe's sons were rising in the wild, upon a clearing in a wood, Amos had built his cot. He tilled his little farm and lived contented with his lot. A just, peace-loving man was he, kind unto all and true. And well his ever-open door the wandering Indian knew. But often were the settlers' lands by force or fraud obtained, and to the red man dispossessed, revenge alone remained. And round the blazing tire of logs, when winter nights were cold, to shuddering listeners dreadful tales of Indian rage were told. But Amos feared not, though his home all undefended lay, and still his ever bolted door was open night and day. One morn a neighbor passed in haste, "Indians, they say, are knives, so Amos, bolt your door tonight and keep your powder dry."
"My friend," said he, "the God I serve commands me not to kill, and sooner would I yield my life than disobey his will. One gun I have but used alone against the wolf or bear. To point it at my fellow man my hand would never dare. But I shall put the thing away, they shall not see it here. For the old gun in hands unskilled might do some harm, I fear. Besides, the Indians are my friends, they would not do me ill. Here they have found an open door, and they shall find it still."
Well said the neighbor as he went, "My faith is not so clear. If wretches come to take my life, I mean to sell it dear." But the good wife of Amos stood and listened with affright. "Unless," she said, "that door is fast, I shall not sleep tonight." And with her words, as women can, she urged her husband sore, till for the sake of household peace, at last he barred the door. Then went to rest, and soon the wife was wrapped in slumbers deep. But Amos turned and tossed about, and vainly tried to sleep. Then came a voice within his heart, a mild rebuke it bore. It whispered, "Thou of little faith, why hast thou barred thy door? Weak is that poor defense of thine against a hostile band. Stronger than the strongest fortress is the shadow of thy hand. Hast thou not said these many times that I have the power to save? As when my servant's trembling feet were sinking neath the wave, now let thy actions with thy words in full accord agree. Rise quickly and unbar the door and trust alone in me." Then Amos from his bed arose and softly trod the floor, crept down the stairs and noiselessly unbarred the cottage door. He looked with trust into the night, starlight it was and still, and slowly rose the waning moon behind the tree-ringed hill. He looked with trustful, reverent gaze up to the starry sky, as meets a child with loving glance a tender father's eye. The cloud was lifted from his brow, his doubts were over now. The cool air breathed a kiss of peace upon his tranquil brow. Then back to his forsaken bed he slowly groped his way, and slept the slumber of the just until the dawn of day. That night a painted warrior band through the dark forest sped, with steps as light upon the leaves as panther's stealthy tread. They reached the farm, "We make no war with good and faithful men." The foremost Indian turned and said, "Here dwells a son of Penn." "But brother, if still his heart is right, how shall we surely know?"
Answered another child, "Time brings change and oft turns friend to foe."
Said the first one, I will go and gently try the door. If open still, it proves his heart is as it was before. It yielded and they entered in. Across the room they stepped.
And came where Amos and his wife,
calm and unconscious, slept. With tomahawk and scalping knife, they stood beside the pair. A solemn stillness filled the room. An angel guard was there. The eye saw eye and seemed to say, how sound the good men sleep. And may they rest and fear no ill whom the great spirit keeps. Then noiselessly they left the room and closed the door behind. And on their deadly war trail passed some other prey to find. And horror shrieked around their steps and bloodshed marked their way. And many homes were desolate when rose another day. But Amos with a thankful heart greeted the morning light and knew not until after years how near was death that night.